okay, we've alluded to this previously, and you probably can figure this out on your own, but let's do a little quick section on break-even analysis. So when we look at our information here on the bicycle company, what we're looking for now is a target profit of zero. And so we have a net operating income here of $20,000. And previous to this, we've even said break-even point is 400 because that would make the contribution margin equal at 80, equal to the fixed expenses, so it would break even. But there's an easy way to fix that or find that if you're not if the problem gets a little more complex. So let's look at this equation: profits equal contribution margin times Q, or the quantity, minus fixed expenses. And if we want to know break-even, we simply set profits equal to zero and solve for Q, the quantity of amount of bikes that we have to have. So if we look at that, we can see that zero equals 200 times Q plus 80,000 of fixed expenses. 80,000 divided by 200 equals Q. A little quick algebra there, no big deal. And you got 400 bikes is your break-even point. The other thing we could do is go into it in terms of unit sales in contribution margin ratio, and just look at it as fixed expenses divided by contribution margin per unit. Fixed expenses divided by contribution margin per unit, you have $80,000 in fixed expenses divided by $200 per unit to cover them. So how many units do you need? If it's units times contribution margin equal fixed expenses, it all equals zero, they balance, right? Then simply divide by the number contribution margin, and you'll find how many units you need to cover your break-even point. So the break-even point can also be done with dollars. So suppose a racing bicycle wants to compute sales dollars required to break even or earn target profit of zero. So we use contribution margin times sales. So instead of quantity, which would be 400 bikes, we use it times sales. And so when we look at this, we find that profit equals contribution margin ratio times sales minus fixed expenses. So it's 40% of sales minus $80,000. So we have $80,000 divided by 40%, or $200,000 in sales. 400 bikes, $500 a piece, $200,000. So you can either get the 400 bikes or you can get the $200,000, depending on which answer helps you the most. So let's take that one step further. And we look at our coffee clutch, little quick check. And coffee clutch is the espresso stand down the street, $1.49, 36 cents, fixed expenses, $1,300. In this case, it has an average of 2,100 cups sold each month. What is the break-even point in dollars? So we look at this and we think, oh, okay, so this is an interesting question for what we just covered. And all we have to do is take the fixed expenses divided by the contribution margin ratio, and we have $1,300 fixed expenses, and we've already calculated the contribution margin ratio as 0.75. In other words, 3/4 of every dollar go towards contribution margin, which means you don't have to have too many more dollars other than the $1,300 to cover everything. So you've got $1,300 divided by 0.75, and you would end up with $1,715 worth of coffee you have to sell. So clearly they're doing pretty well at $2,100 cups times $1.49. The second question is, what is break-even in sales units? So what is break-even in sales units? That's pretty straightforward. Fixed expenses divided by contribution margin per unit, $1,300 divided by $1.13 a cup is 1,150 cups. Again, that's not a very high number if you're selling 2,100 on average. So this is doing pretty well. The coffee company seems to be doing a little bit more than the bicycle company. But these are pretty easy numbers for you to calculate. So it's important that you get a little bit of practice with this. Clearly, this isn't the hardest thing in the world to know. Any company that you're going to work for that is in this area where they're pricing is probably going to already have this down for all their products. They'll have the accountants and the treasurers handling all this. But if you're in a small business, this could be very helpful in a small business. A lot of you people know some people in small businesses that work in small businesses, and knowing contribution margin, knowing a little bit of price, volume, quantity, this could be very helpful to them. In fact, let's keep going in the next video.